Good morning. The church and the family of Christy Wigglepowski welcome you today as we celebrate the life of a beloved wife, a mother, daughter, sister, aunt, and friend. As we gather together today, we are grateful for life and the gift of the life of Christy Wigglepowski. No doubt our hearts are filled with many mixed feelings, feelings of sadness and sorrow over the loss of a family member and friend. But also, we gather here today with the feelings of joy, knowing that Christy is today with God in paradise. Jesus said these words. He said, "I am the resurrection and the life, and whoever lives and believes in me, though he die, will have eternal life." God, pour out your amazing grace so that in our pain we may find comfort, in our sorrow we may find hope, and in death we may experience resurrection. So let us pray. Lord of heaven and creator of all things, we thank you for the gift of life and the promise of eternal life that comes only through your Son, Jesus Christ. We pray for our time together this morning during this service that it will honor you and the life you gave us in Christy Wigglepowski. Now together, let us pray the prayer of St. Francis. The words will be on the screen. Let us join together. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. Where there is sadness, joy. Our divine master, grant that I may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, and to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive, it is in pardoning that we are pardoned, and it is in dying that we are born to eternal life. We pray this in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And now let us stand as we sing our opening hymn, "How Great Thou Art."
When I in awesome wonder seated.
Psalm 23 that we are about to hear is filled with imagery to convey comfort and calm to the soul of those who are part of God's flock by faith in Jesus Christ. It states that if a person puts their faith in God, they need not fear anything, including death. On February 16th, the Good Shepherd led our sister Christy to paradise. Christy had a personal relationship with the shepherd. She knew the promise of God's provision. She knew she was forgiven. And she knew that the shepherd was a companion here on earth. And now she rests in the eternal companionship in heaven. Let us listen to these words of hope and comfort.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yeah, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup runs over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Please stand if you are able and join us in singing In the Garden.
From the Old Testament, Nehemiah 8, verse 10. Nehemiah said, "Go and enjoy choice food and sweet drinks, and send some to those who have nothing prepared. This day is holy to our Lord. Do not grieve, for the joy of the Lord is your strength." Isaiah 55, verses 9 through 12. As the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. As the rain and the snow come down from heaven, and do not return to it without watering the earth and making it bud and flourish, so that it yields seed for the sower and bread for the eater. So is my word that goes out from my mouth. It will not return to me empty, but will accomplish what I desire and achieve the purpose for which I sent it. You will go out in joy and be led forth in peace. The mountains and hills will burst into song before you, and the trees of the field will clap their hands.
Christy or what? All right, let's give her up. Let's just all clap. Clap for joy. Definitely beautiful. Thank you. We are about to enter into a time of cherished memories. And as you know, Christy and the memories you share are numerous. Christy meant so much to all of us. Many memories we hold dear in our hearts forever. Tommy, Christy's husband, is going to come forward and share memories of his dear, beloved wife. However, I'm also going to put you to task. After the service, we invite you to have lunch with all in the gathering place. And I ask you at some time, while you sit around table, to share a memory of Christy and what she meant to your life. May she be the focus of your time together around table. Can you do that? That would be wonderful. For when we love someone, their memories stay alive in the stories that we tell. And so now let us hear from Tommy.
I just want to thank everybody for coming, of course. It means so much to our families. This is going to be really difficult, so I'm going to do my best. I want to thank all our family and friends for all their love, support, and prayers. It means so much to all of us. But I'd like to give an extra special thanks to my father-in-law, Jim. If I was unable to go to an appointment with Christy or help her with something, he was there every step of the way. He was literally my second set of ears for the doctors. He would fill me in on day-to-day things that I wasn't able to attend, and I'm just so proud and very blessed to be able to call him my father-in-law, and I love you, sir. Christy and I met back in February of 1998, and as the obituary says, it truly was love at first sight. We were introduced by our dear friend Brenda, who was also our maid of honor in our wedding. We started dating right away, and within 8 months of dating, we had already moved in together. 2 months later, on Christmas Eve, we were engaged. And some people even told us, "What are you thinking? Are you sure?" But we were thinking to ourselves, when you know, you know. 2 years later, in October of 2000, we were married. And that was beyond the greatest day of our lives. Almost exactly 2 years later, our son Kyle was born, which was equally one of the greatest days of our lives. Watching Christy turn into such a wonderful mother, wonderful and loving mother, was a blessing. She liked all the little things in life, from waking up in the morning, getting a cup of coffee, and watching the birds outside. Playing with our many dogs through the years, to watering her garden and harvesting her tomatoes. She loved her plants and sitting around the fire pit outside, as well as spending long summer weekends up on her family boat. We even had a yearly tradition of going to Cedar Point and Put-in Bay every year for her birthday. I even loved the little things with Christy, like us just driving in the car and listening to her sing songs on the radio. Christy was always the life of the party and always bright in the room she was in. She was one of the most selfless people I have ever met, and she would always try to find a way to help people out. Even when it inconvenienced her or if she had problems of her own at the time, Christy always made time for her family and friends just to talk about anything in their day-to-day lives, whether on the phone or in person. She was also a volunteer at one time at Harvard Elementary Library for a few years to spend more time with Kyle and to read to kids. She also loved cheering on Kyle at all his baseball games through the years. Even during her long battle with cancer, she always had a smile on her face. She was eager to spread good advice and would cook amazing food for people whenever she could. Christy found a new scripture and wrote it down for every single day, and her faith and devotion to the church were also incredible to witness and watch and grow, which absolutely helped give her such a positive mindset and outlook on life. I really do believe that her faith and constant positivity has made me a better person as well. Her favorite thing was helping others, and with her career, she was able to do exactly that. Christy absolutely loved her job as an interior designer and always got a great sense of accomplishment when completing a project for a client. For those of you who don't know, she also played a massive role in designing this church, so it really is a part of her. She always told me about her work with such enthusiasm and excitement, and as if she was already for a new, if she was already for a new day, excuse me. When she finally got her position at ProSource, she had a great feeling of fulfillment, love, and truly enjoyed working with her coworkers. She felt her job finally pertained to her degree, and it was her dream job. Holidays with Christy were always the best. She had a love and passion for decorating. Every single holiday, there would be a new and unique decoration everywhere, and her attention to detail was unrivaled. She loved entertaining as well for every special occasion. She would put together giant charcuterie boards or massive vegetable trays to share with anyone and everyone. Christy was truly a blessing for anyone to have in their life, and I know she will be very deeply missed by all. As for myself, words cannot describe how much I will miss you. You will always be in my thoughts and heart.
I will always continue to love you more and more every day. You will always be my wife, my best friend, and the same applies to our son, Kyle. Our family is so happy and relieved that your pain and suffering is over. You are at peace in God's loving arms where you always wanted to be. And we all have no doubt that you are one of his several angels watching down on us with every waking moment with your constant unbreakable happiness and joy. And I know you will always be looking down on our son, Kyle, and watching all his accomplishments throughout his life in the future.
The gospel reading this morning comes from John 14. Don't be troubled. Trust in God, trust also in me. My Father's house has room to spare. If that weren't the case, would I have told you I'm going to prepare a place for you? When I go and prepare a place for you, I will return and take you to be with me, so that you, where I am, you will be also. You know the way to the place I'm going. I won't leave you as orphans. I will come to you. Soon the world will no longer see me, but you will see me. Because I live, you will live also. I have spoken these things to you while I am with you. The companion, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you everything and will remind you of everything that I've told you. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give you. I give to you not as the world gives. Don't be troubled or afraid.
Let's pray. God, we thank you for the gift of Christy Wigopowski. As we reflect briefly on her life, may all glory and honor go to you, the creator and the sustainer of all things. In Jesus' name we pray. Well, we've come together today to praise God and to be a witness to our Christian faith and to celebrate and honor the life of Christy Wigopowski. To Tommy and Kyle, and to the entire Wigopowski and Page families, I offer my sympathy now to you as your life goes on without this precious loved one. Tommy, you're the love of her life. Thank you for sharing such beautiful words. She adored you, and everything you shared was felt in return. Tommy, you mentioned to me that Christy's strength and positivity made you a better person through the years. Just know that she found joy every day with you also. And Kyle, boy, was she extremely proud of you. And she loves seeing you grow into the man that you are. You're a product of the love of your parents, that your parents shared. There's no greater love than that of a mother for her child. She had an abundant amount for her little boy. The loss of the loved one is probably the most difficult time in life. And grief is never comfortable for any of us. But because God loved us, we are able to gather in love, and not only for our sister Christy, but to support and love on Christy's family and close friends. Peace comes when we discover, accept, and appreciate God's perfect timing. When you know and accept the promises of Jesus, you can see beyond this moment of loss to a bright and glorious future for all who die with faith in Jesus. We can celebrate because Christy is with her Heavenly Father without any more pain and any more suffering. The Bible doesn't say not to grieve, but rather it says as a Christian dies, we do not grieve as those who have no hope. We as Christians have hope. The death of a Christian is a wonderful thing when we consider Christ won the battle over death for us, so we can live in eternity forever with him, Christ our Savior. See, Christy is no longer the subject of time as we know. After Christy took her last breath, the next thing she saw was Jesus' face. Christy is in heaven right now. And if you have surrendered your life to Jesus, you will see her again. Now, in crafting a final message for someone like Christy, you try to find characteristics that seem to stand out in that person's life. Well, there are many, and the family shared these words to describe her character. Generous, positive, outgoing, determined, unselfish, caring, faithful, friendly, kind, strong, and creative. but the word that radiated from everyone I spoke to about Christy was joy. Christy was full of joy, and she wanted everyone else to experience it also. Joy is possible in our lives because of that peace that God supplies. Joy is a result of peace. Peace is one of the great gifts from God. Our world speaks often of peace, but our world can't ever understand the fullness of peace. To our world, peace is the absence of something, the absence of war, the absence of heartache, the absence of strife. However, the peace of the Lord is so much more. It's not just about what's not there, but it's about what is. Jesus. It's all about Jesus. Where Jesus is and where Jesus has done his work, where Jesus had created faith and reconciliation, there is a fullness of God's peace. There is this peace that passes understanding, and Christy had it. There is a peace that cannot be overcome by changing winds in this life. There is true peace, and that peace that I think of when I think Christy. Christy lived in the peace of the Lord. And Christy has now departed in the peace of the Lord. Christy was a woman who knew her salvation rested safely in the hands of the Good Shepherd. And that knowledge gave her peace. That lifted the burdens of her life so that she could be a fun-loving, joy-filled woman who made you smile. She was filled with the peace of the Lord. It was the core of Christy because Jesus lived in her heart. Christy was born and raised in this church, baptized, confirmed, married, and worshiped regularly, giving praise to the one who holds all peace. Christy's faith was strong. She found peace and joy in reading, studying, and journaling the Word of God. God's Word speaks peace into our chaotic lives. Christy knew her strength and peace came from knowing and engaging in God's Word. This was not a peace that is the absence of busyness or strife, but a true peace that comes from being united with a Redeemer. The peace that fills us from head to toe, even when we don't feel particularly peaceful. For it is not a peace that relies on us or our emotions or our schedule or our circumstances. It is a peace of the Lord. It is a peace that comes from knowing how the story ends with the resurrection of the body into life everlasting. That peace allowed Christy to look past the struggles and the burdens in her walk with cancer. Her poor body had been through so much in the last few years. And yet she kept her eyes focused on Jesus through it all. What an example for us. We just heard, don't be troubled or afraid. And Christy wasn't. She knew that her salvation was secure. She knew that no matter what failures or shortcomings might be part of her path or her story, her Lord would not fail her. He would fulfill his promises. He would sustain her in the true faith until life everlasting. Christy lived a life rooted in the promises of God. Yeah, the trees and even us can clap our hands. Amen? Christy was a combination of what I like to say, Mary and Martha, both sitting at the feet of the Lord, hearing the word, while also actively serving him by serving the people of this world. Christy gave selfishly of her time. As Tommy mentioned, Christy served as our trustee chair and used her skills to choose the colors, the fabrics, the flooring, and the furniture for this church facility. She was a great leader and a motivator. Even though Christy was stricken with cancer, she would even share on social media and with others the good and the bad of the situation, but with joy. She even guided and encouraged friends that were facing the same fears associated with cancer. She was still giving in the midst of her cancer. And yet she remained positive and would always say, God's got this. God's got it. And now God has her resting in his mighty, grace-filled arms with no more pain, no more suffering. And Christy's laugh, wasn't it infectious? It was great, wasn't it? And her smile was so welcoming. One of Christy's mottos was, find joy in every day. All right? When you leave this place today, do not forget to share with others, to find joy in every day. She enjoyed peace and joy, not in the complex things, but in the simple things of life. Christy loved spending time in God's creation in the garden, in the kitchen, and get-togethers, the car, having a cup of coffee, you name it. She had joy in anything and anywhere she went. Her creative spirit oozed out of her in so many ways. Now, even though she loved to cook and entertain, I understand that Christy had a passion to dine out to the nice restaurants, right? Especially enjoying checking out those new places. Some of them are a little strange, right? But she loved to savor that glass of wine, to sit back and relax with friends. She took time to slow down, soak up the joy of life. Christy loved spending time with her family. She loved all of you deeply, whether it was time spent at home or on or by the lake. She referred to her dad as her rock. And she knew she was daddy's little girl. She was so grateful for all the time spent, no matter how far away it was. You were there for her. All of you were. And thank you for being such a loving and caring family. What a blessing you are to all around you. As many memories as we have and hold of Christy, as fun as she was to be around, the sad reality remains that her time on this earth was always destined to come to an end. And that day will come for each one of us also. None of us will escape it. However, for those of us who hold Jesus in our hearts, the promise is that we too will depart in peace. Jesus says, peace I leave with you. My peace I give you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled and do not be afraid. This is a peace that will sustain, support, and surround us when our hearts are troubled and lonely. It is a peace that no one can take away from us. Even as we pass through the valley of the shadow of death, Christy had this peace, and she knew that there was a place ready for her, and she would be able to spend eternity in her new home. Jesus says, "Let not your hearts be troubled. Where I am, you may be also." He says these things because he is the one and only Son of God, sent to save a world full of sinners. He says these things because he knows the place he has prepared for us. He knows the sins he took to the cross for us. He knows the reality of his victory over death. He knows that he will rise up on the last day. That's why we can proclaim, "Let not our hearts be troubled." That is why he says what he says. That's why he promises what he promises. That's why he comforts us with these words. It is because of who he is and what he knows. So we trust our faithful Savior, knowing his promise and gift. We confess our faith in him boldly when we say, "I believe in the resurrection of the body and the life everlasting." Christy is in the hands of Jesus in death, just as she was every day in life. We are safe in the hands of Jesus too, not alone, but with him always, just as he has promised. And there will be a place for us. And there, just as there was for the disciples who Jesus was talking to in this passage. The Bible tells us that Jesus is at the right hand of God the Father. the creator of heaven and earth. And scripture says, no one comes to the Father except through me. Christy believed. She knew that Jesus died on the cross and physically rose from the dead. She placed her trust, her eternal future, into the hands of Jesus. So if you don't have a relationship with God, now is the time. Don't wait another moment. Christy had that relationship. She knew the love of Christ, and she shared that love with you in her own unique, creative way. She was able to walk with the Lord every day on earth, and now her life is spent in eternity. See, true peace and joy comes from the Lord, from being united to him, from holding him in our hearts through faith. And that's exactly what he's given you. That's what he gave Christy. Yes, we grieve. But we can celebrate the gift God gave us in Christy and the eternal life she now has with her Father in heaven. On February 16th, Christy fell asleep. And when she did, the greatest arms in the universe slipped underneath her, gently lifted her up, and carried her to a place that is safe and secure. Place that is hers and her very own forever. As Christy arose, she disturbed no one, and the world didn't hear the voice that summoned her. Beautiful voice. Jesus say, "Welcome home, child. Welcome home." May the same peace and joy that filled the heart of Christy Wiegelpowski fill your hearts and minds today as we celebrate victory in Jesus. Amen. May God bless the memory of Christy Wiegelpowski, who loves God and will dwell with him forever. Let us pray. Oh God, our Heavenly Father, we thank you for Christy. Help us to love and serve you in this world that we may enter into your joy in the world to come. God of love, we thank you for all with which you have blessed us, even to this day, for the gifts of joy in days of health and strength, and for the gifts of your abiding presence and promise in days of pain and grief. We praise you for home and for our home and for our friends, for our baptism and our place in your church, and with all who faithfully lived and died. Above all else, we thank you for Jesus, who knew our griefs, who died our death, and rose for our sake, and who lives and prays for us now and forevermore. Amen. And now together, let us say the prayer that Jesus himself taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. And now let us stand and sing our final hymn, Living for Jesus.
Striving to please him in all that we do.
Please be seated.
Well, that really spoke of Christy, didn't it? Living with Jesus. Let us pray. Oh God, oh Heavenly Father, we thank you for Christy. Thank you for sharing her life with ours. All that you have given us is yours. As first you gave Christy to us, we give her back to you. Thank you for receiving Christy Wiegelpowski into your arms of your mercy. Raise Christy up with all your people. Receive us also and raise us into new life. And so may Christ be your source of life and beauty so that he may nourish and strengthen you. May he be your joy so that his love will live through you to all those around you. May God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit be with you so he may bear much good fruit through you now and forevermore. And Lord, for the meal we are about to share, may you bless the food that came from your earth to the table. Blessings of appreciation for the hands that have prepared it, and God, for the hands that get to clean it all up. Let us indeed celebrate the victory Christy has received in you. In Jesus' name we pray. May the peace of the Lord and the joy of the Lord be with you. We invite you now to dinner with us. The family will lead through the window over there, and then we will sit in the gathering space. May God bless you.